मनाओ जश्न ए मोहब्बत की, खून की बू न रही। बरस के खुल गए बारूद के सियाह बादल, बुझी बुझी सी है जंगों की आखिरी बिजली। महक रही है गुलाबों से ताशकंद की शाम, खुदा करे ये शबनम यूं ही बरसती रहे। जमी हमेशा लहू के लिए तरसती रहे, जमी हमेशा लहू के लिए तरसती रहे।
A man who led India through one of the most difficult times of her history. A man who believed in a simple life of high ideals. A little man who was giant in Indian politics. Here is another hint. That man was born on this very day. If you are thinking of Mohandas Gandhi, well, you are not entirely incorrect. But your answer is certainly incomplete, because today we mark the birth anniversary of not only the Mahatma, but also our second Prime Minister, Lal Bahadur Shastri. But Shastri ji was not very far from Gandhi ji when it came to his character and ideals. He became a Gandhian very early in his youth. In fact, he participated in the non-cooperation movement when he was just 16 years old. And just like Gandhi ji, he too was a man of principle to the core. This is illustrated by a very moving incident from his life. Before independence, Shastri ji was in prison for his nationalist activities. Once, while he was still in jail, his son fell seriously ill. He got permission to visit his home for exactly 1 week. Sadly, his son did not recover in a week's time. Even as his sick child lay crying for his father's company, he returned to jail. He had to keep his word. Such was the strength of his character. Shastriji also shared Gandhiji's ideal of simplicity. Once while traveling in a government vehicle on a hot summer's day, he got the driver to stop the car, went to a street vendor selling sugarcane juice, drank a glass, paid the money and returned to the car without the vendor realizing that he had served the juice to the Home Minister of the nation. Neither his clothes nor his demeanor has shown any trace of a person of importance. But Shastri ji also differed from Mahatma Gandhi in one very important way. When Pakistan made incursions into Indian territory, Shastri ji's conviction and boldness were indispensable in boosting the morale of our country's forces. Whereas Gandhi ji was a pacifist who would have preferred dialogue rather than a military response, Shastri ji made it clear that force shall be met with force. Here is an extract from Shastri ji's address to the nation towards the end of the war of 1965.
Hum jante hain ki Pakistan ne kitna anuchit aur berahmi ka kaam kiya. Din dahade अमृतसर की शहरी जनता पर बमबारी करना ऐसा काम है जिसकी कड़ी से कड़ी निंदा की जाए। उन्होंने जानबूझकर यह काम किया और लोगों के जान माल को गहरा नुकसान पहुंचाया।
Did you notice the tone with which Shastri ji spoke? Even though he was condemning Pakistan's actions, we cannot find a trace of anger in his voice. Accepting the reality and controlling one's emotion are the hallmarks of a great leader. And Shastri ji accepted the reality not only in war, but in India's economic policy as well. Shastri ji's predecessor, Jawaharlal Nehru, was a passionate socialist and had brought India's industries under tight government control. When Shastri ji became the Prime Minister, he accepted the facts before him. Tough state control over the economy was not as beneficial as Nehru had believed it to be. Shastri ji realized that India's industries now needed some freedom to grow and attain their potential. He ensured that industries got this freedom. What this shows is Shastri ji's flexibility and practicality. He did not stubbornly stick to the mere ideology of socialism. He wanted concrete results for India. But Shastriji's greatest contribution to our economy lies in supporting the Green Revolution and White Revolution. It was Shastriji who supported the import of high-yielding variety seeds in agriculture, which led to the Green Revolution. This made India self-sufficient in food grains. Thus, Shastriji had been true to his famous words, Jai Jawan, Jai Kisan.
छोटा कद महान व्यक्तित्व, छोटा कद महान व्यक्तित्व और जिगर में स्वाभिमान, मंत्र अनोखा दिया राष्ट्र को जय जवान जय किसान। सादगी की प्रतिमूरत तुम, सादगी की प्रतिमूरत तुम और भौतिकता से अनजान, मंत्र अनोखा दिया राष्ट्र को जय जवान जय किसान। सन 65 की जंग हुई जो, सन 65 की जंग हुई जो घुटनों में आया पाकिस्तान, मंत्र अनोखा दिया राष्ट्र को जय जवान जय किसान। गुदड़ी की लाल नमन तुझे नतमस्तक सारा हिंदुस्तान, मंत्र अनोखा दिया राष्ट्र को जय जवान जय किसान।
Today, the coronavirus pandemic has brought us to a situation where drawing lessons from Shastriji's life could be of great help. Shastriji taught us the value of living by principle. He showed us the powerful role of discipline in overcoming challenges. Discipline is indeed the crying need of our day. It is indispensable to rein in the spread of the coronavirus. Another value which we must learn from Shastriji is the acceptance of reality and maintaining one's composure. In this pandemic, there are few things that we can control. We must accept what comes in our way and keep pushing ahead with conviction. Shastriji used to have a couplet inscribed on a wooden plate in his room.
Nanak nanhe hi raho, jaisi nanhi doob, aur rook sukh jayega, doob khub ki khub.
This means, remain as small as you can, as small as grass. The other plants will wither away, but the grass remains evergreen. These lines sum up the human being that Shastriji tried to be. Even after the pandemic, one lesson from Shastriji that shall remain ever relevant for us is being modest, humble, and simple.